إلى الأمام تقدموا إلى الجهاد فلتنفروا. What does it look like, Islamic State?
Islamic State, really, it is just that. It is a state.
Raqqa in Syrië. Hoofdkwartier van de strijdgroep die inmiddels een grondgebied controleert ter grootte van Jordanië. Met 6 miljoen inwoners. Een strijdgroep die zich niet alleen Islamitische Staat noemt, maar dat in veel opzichten ook daadwerkelijk is.
They seem to be the most organized group that has managed to emerge in the Middle East in the last, say, decade or more. And this is why they're very effective.
In the past, we've looked at Al-Qaeda, for example. That's a terrorist group. We could say that the ISIS, when it was operating as such, was a very sophisticated insurgency. But now what these guys have done is they have achieved a state. They hold territory, they administer social services, they collect taxes, they provide for their citizens. And effectively, that's what they have. They have a state, and that's how they see themselves, and that's how they conduct themselves.
Dit is de leider van de Islamitische Staat, Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. Hij heeft zichzelf uitgeroepen tot kalif.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
De kalif leidt een regering die bestaat uit 7 ministers en een militaire raad van 3 personen. De tweede man, Abu Muslim al-Turkmani, staat boven 6 gouverneurs, die elk een provincie besturen in de Islamitische Staat.
IS is daar heel erg gevoelig voor. Men wil voortdurend als staat, als kalifaat aangesproken worden.
Want?
Want men zegt, dat zijn we. We zijn niet gewoon een groep zoals Jabhat al-Nusra of Ahrar al-Sham of Al-Qaeda of wie dan ook. Wij zijn echt een staat en dat brengt bepaalde normen met zich mee. En die normen die handhaven wij, zoals elke staat zijn normen en regels en wetten handhaaft. En dat betekent dus ook dat zij zich het recht toe-eigenen om bijvoorbeeld bij een dief handen af te hakken. Want, zeggen zij, wij zijn een staat, wij hebben hier wetten en zoals elk ander land in de wereld is het onze taak om onze wetten te handhaven en die af te dwingen.
In het zelfverklaarde kalifaat moet iedereen verplicht 5 keer per dag bidden. Een religieuze politie ziet erop toe dat de mensen zich aan de regels houden. Er zijn islamitische rechtbanken ingericht, waar recht wordt gesproken volgens de sharia. Er worden middeleeuwse straffen uitgedeeld in het kalifaat. Met instemming van, in elk geval, een deel van de bevolking.
Whilst we from the West see clearly all the brutality and obviously the residents see it too, for the residents life is slightly different because in our minds that's what life is like every day. There's just beheadings happening from morning till night. It's not like that. In fact, in a lot of places, insecurity has been replaced with security. So if you lived in Mosul, you lived under danger. If you lived in Raqqa, you lived under danger because the government was not able to provide for your people and there was death squads, there was random bouts of violence and so on. Now, what you have in those areas is a degree of stability, is a degree of calm. People have greater confidence if their children leave the house to go to the shop. They won't be killed or disappear in some sort of arbitrary fashion. So there is a sense among some people that life has moderately got better. They know it's a bad regime to live under, but the immediate short-term effect for them is in some senses a better life.
In de straten van Raqqa pronken strijders van IS met panzervoertuigen en tanks die ze hebben buitgemaakt op het Iraakse leger. De Islamitische Staat vecht met de modernste wapens en er is ook voldoende geld in kas.
Er is een tijd geleden gezegd dat ze een bank hadden beroofd, geloof ik, in Irak. Wat ze echt honderden miljoenen dollars op heeft geleverd. Ze hebben natuurlijk gevangenen die ze voor los geld kunnen verkopen. En ik geloof dat ze dat in sommige gevallen ook nog wel lukt ook. Dus daar kunnen ze geld aan verdienen. Ze verdienen geld aan de olieverkoop in Irak.
Someone described them as the world's newest petrol state. So that's a good way to think about them. They have oil wells, they are selling that back to Assad, they're selling it on the black market to raise a huge amount of cash.
You're no longer fighting an insurgency. We are an Islamic army and a state.
We think that the Islamic State are those group of barbarians coming from the desert and they're beheading and they're killing, which they are doing. But at the same time, they're a very modern organization. They're very well equipped. They fight in a very modern way. So the reality is it's the Iraqi army that's this archaic, old organization based on corruption, almost like in Ottoman times. While the fighters from the Islamic State, those are very modern fighters. They use pickup trucks, they use mobile force, like the Taliban in the 90s. You know, that was a very energized, militarized group that managed to conquer land. And the same thing is happening now.
The terrorist group known as ISIL must be degraded and ultimately destroyed. This group has terrorized all who they come across in Iraq and Syria. There can be no reasoning, no negotiation with this brand of evil. The only language understood by killers like this is the language of force.
The Islamic State can be defeated, but it cannot be defeated at the moment in terms of the mission that Obama has constructed. To simply bomb them from the air will degrade some of their capacity. They will lose some weapons, they will lose some fighters. But what else will happen? You cannot uproot an entire entity that has anywhere from 10 to 12, maybe 15,000 fighters, has all these other 5-6 million people living under its territory. You can't uproot this without putting boots on the ground. I'm not saying they should do that. I'm saying it's impossible, it's inconceivable to see how it can happen without putting boots on the ground. Obama's not going to do that. So, and no Western countries right now. There's no momentum to do, there's no public opinion to do that. So in the absence of that, can the Islamic State be defeated right now? No.